Ebiru's fate was revealed by Joel Senyonyi, the Committee on Commissions, Statutory Authorities and State Enterprises Chairperson, following explosive meetings held with UNBS to respond to issues raised in the June 2022 Auditor General's report. Senyonyi asked Ebiru not to do the same with the latest directive so as to allow smooth running of affairs at the standards body.
We handed him over to police. He's actually property of police. He's out on bond. Police is investigating. I'm told the IGG has also summoned them. So it's possible that because of now where this matter is headed to prosecution and so on, that someone can say, let me apologize, let me withdraw, and everything is wiped out. That's not how it works.
Senyonyi called on the board and top management to clean up the mess at UNBS, saying such infighting could impact on the quality of lives of Ugandans because of the crucial role that the bureau plays in the daily lives of Ugandans.
You can apologize, you can whatever. It's not about us forgiving you or saying, okay, you have withdrawn or whatever the case might be, yeah? Because you see, the bribery allegations were tabled. He admitted. We have screenshots of WhatsApp message exchanges and all of that.
Charles Musekura, the board chairperson of UNBS, in response, assured staff at UNBS aligned to Ebiru not to be scared of witch hunt at their jobs, but vowed to undertake a thorough cleanup exercise and get rid of the bad apples at the bureau.
Of hearing and stop witch hunting, because we are all one family. This thing is not going to get us very far, I'm afraid.
Meanwhile, the executive director of Uganda National Bureau of Standards, David Ebiru, has withdrawn his statement earlier made that he bribed the board with 100 million shillings for extension of his contract, saying the remarks were made then when he had grudges with the board members, but the two warring parties have since reconciled.
One of the statements I made during the Hale days of our exchange was really over-publicized when we were both attacking, both sides attacking. And so I wanted to take this opportunity to inform you, Chair and members, that that exchange has ended in reconciliation or harmony.
Mr. Ebiru and I are not enemies. There is nothing we can crush on. What we are doing is in the best interest of the organization and of this country. We have a very big mandate to serve this country, the public.
Joel Senyonyi, the chairperson COSASE, described the latest development as interesting, noting that Ebiru has a right to say whatever he wants to say, but his latest admission and attempts to withdraw the earlier remarks won't deter the committee from the probe.
I find this interesting. Of course, people have a right to say whatever it is that they would like to say. What's important is we have a statement on record. There's evidence of messages, WhatsApp messages, and so on. There's an investigation going on by police. Now the IGG, I'm hoping this is not to say, let me retract, because police is now investigating, IGG is investigating, and that kind of...
In the same vein, John Chwanuka, a meteorologist working with Uganda National Bureau of Standards, succumbed to pressure and collapsed midway in COSASE hearing and was rushed to receive emergency health care.
I don't want someone to die and then say the family says he died because COSASE asked hard questions.
Chwanuka's troubles stemmed from a number of queries that were raised by the Shadow Internal Affairs Minister Abdallah Chwanuka pertaining to a transaction he undertook during the 2021-2022 financial year. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.